From this tutorial, we will start new series on AutoCAD 3D basics. In this series of tutorials, we will learn step by step all the AutoCAD 3D commands. Click here, then scroll down and select acadiso.dwt. Then to bring here 3D tools, click here and select 3D modeling. Now here only X and Y axis are shown. To view the Z axis, click here on unsaved view and select SE isometric. Then to shift this UCS icon on the left side, type UCS icon, enter and select no origin. In order to create 3D object, at first you will have to create 2D sketch on XY plane, and then you will have to give thickness to it in Z axis. Now here 3D tools has been added on the left side, like modeling, mesh and solid editing, and 2D commands has been shifted on the right side. So at first we will create 2D sketch. For that, click on line, then specify first point, make ortho on. Then here you can specify length of line, suppose it is 300, enter. Then you can specify length here, or you can also click. So I will choose the length by clicking here. Then I will track this endpoint and create this rectangle. Press enter. Now I have created this rectangle in XY plane and it is a closed shape. If your shape is open, then it will not create 3D object. Then to convert this rectangle into 3D, click on press pull. Then take your cursor inside the shape which you want to convert into 3D. So it will highlight that shape. Once it highlights the boundary shape, then click there. Then take your cursor on the side where you want to give the thickness. You can give thickness on the upper side or lower side. Suppose I want to give thickness on lower side. Then specify thickness. Suppose my thickness is 75. Enter. Then press pull command is still running. To stop the press pull command, press escape. Now this object is shown in 2D wireframe. To display it in solid look, click here on 2D wireframe and select shaded with edges. Then if you don't want these grids, then you can turn them off from here. Click on this button, so those grids will be turned off. Then suppose I want to create here circular hole and I want to specify some distance from this line and some distance from this line to locate the center of the hole. To create the reference of 3D edges, you will have to click here on this arrow, extract edges, and select copy edges. Then select this edge. Now here it is giving error, a solid must be selected. Now what happened? We created 2D rectangle here and we have given thickness on the lower side. That means our 2D edges are still there, and because of that it is not selecting the solid edges and it is selecting those 2D edges. Therefore it is giving error, a 3D solid must be selected. So here we will press escape, and to remove those edges, what we will do, we will type E, enter, and we will select all the objects using crossing window. Then we don't want to remove this solid object. To cancel the selection of solid object, press shift and select on the solid object. So here you can see that one removed and total four are selected. That means those four lines has been selected and our solid object has been removed from the selection. Then press enter. So those four lines has been deleted. Then again click on copy edges, then select this line, then press enter, then specify base point, then take your cursor on this side and specify distance. Suppose I want distance of 100, type 100, enter, then again click on copy, select this edge, enter, specify base point, take your cursor on this side and give the distance of 200, enter. And to stop the command, you will have to press enter 2 times, enter, enter. Then to create circle, click here on circle command, then specify center point for circle. So our center point is here. Now here it is showing this surface in blue color. The meaning of that is your dynamic UCS is on. Now because of this dynamic UCS, it creates number of problems while changing the UCS. Therefore, what we will do, we will turn off this dynamic UCS. To turn off this dynamic UCS, you will have to click on these three lines, customization, then click here on dynamic UCS. Now here it is showing the dynamic UCS button, then click on it. So here dynamic UCS has been turned off. Then specify the center point. So we want center point at this intersection, click there. Take your cursor away, then specify the radius. Suppose radius is 50, enter. Then to create the hole, click on press pull. Then take your cursor inside this circle, then click. Then to select other portion, click on multiple and select all the remaining portions. Then press enter. Then if you take your cursor on the upper side, then it will create solid object, and if you take your cursor inside the object, then it will create hole. So we want to create hole, therefore we will take our cursor below. Here you can specify the thickness of the hole, or if you want to create a through hole, then you can take your cursor below and click. So here the through hole is created. Then to see that through hole, you will have to press shift and middle mouse button and drag the mouse, so it will orbit it and it will show that hole. Then to remove this line, type E, enter and select those lines and press enter. So in this way you can create holes. Suppose I want to create some rectangular portion here and convert it into 3D. For that again I will click on copy edges. Then I will select this line, enter, specify base point, give the direction and give the distance. Then again click on copy, select this edge, enter, specify base point, take your cursor on this side, then specify the distance. Then click on exit and exit. Then to convert this portion into 3D, click on press pull. Then click inside this portion, take your cursor above, then specify the height and press escape. So in this way you can create the object on the spot, or if you are facing any problem in creating on the spot, you can also create it in the empty space. Suppose I will create one rectangle using rectangle command. Click on rectangle, specify first point, then specify length in x direction. Suppose length in x direction is 50, comma length in y direction is 150. Enter. Then to convert this rectangle into 3D, click on press pull. Then click inside this rectangle, take your cursor above and specify the height. Then press escape. Then suppose I want to place this on this point. So I will have to match this point with this point. So to shift this object here, I will have to make use of move command. Click on move, select this object, enter, then specify base point. So this endpoint will be our base point. Then specify second point. So this endpoint will be our second point. Click there. So this object has been placed there properly. Then to remove this rectangle and these lines, type E, enter and select this rectangle and these lines and press enter. When you create object outside and place it on the existing 3D object, then it will create these two objects. But here you can see that this object was created as a single object. So to join these two objects, you will have to make use of union command. So here is the solid union command. Click on union, then select this object and this object and press enter. So in this way you can join two separate objects. Till now we have created shapes on this horizontal XY plane and we have given thickness in this vertical Z axis. Suppose now I want to create some 2D shape on this surface and I want to give thickness in horizontal direction. So in that case I will have to make this XY vertical and this Z axis horizontal. So to rotate these XY Z axis we will have to change UCS. To change UCS you will have to click here on this arrow near the world in coordinate section and from here you will have to choose your required UCS. If you want to work on this face then you will have to choose right UCS. Using this right UCS you can work on all the face parallel to this face. So I can work on this face or on this back faces also. So I can work using right on this face also. So in this way you can work using right face on all the parallel faces to this face. And if you want to work on this face then you will have to use front UCS. Using front UCS you can work on this surface and on these surfaces also. And if you want to work on this surface then you will have to use this top UCS. So using these three UCS you can work on any surface of the solid. So I want to create something on this surface so I will choose this right UCS. So click on right. So here you can see that XY axis is vertical and Z is horizontal. Now suppose we will create one circle here. Click on circle. You can also use copy edges if you want to locate the object accurately. Suppose I will track this midpoint, take my cursor below and specify center point here. Or you can also specify here distance. Suppose I want center point at a distance of 80. So I will type 80, enter, then take your cursor away and specify radius. Suppose radius is 40, enter. Then to convert this circle into 3D, again click on press pull, then click inside this circle. If you want to create solid object, take your cursor on this side, and if you want to create hole then you will have to take cursor on this side. So I want to create solid object so I will take my cursor on this side and specify the length. Then press escape. Then to orient it properly click here and click on AC isometric. So it will show original orientation. Then I want to create something on this surface. For that click here and choose front UCS. Here Z axis has been oriented in this direction. Now this XY plane is parallel to this surface. Suppose I want to create here rectangular shape. Click on rectangle. Then I will track this endpoint. I will specify here first point. Then I will specify here second point. Then again, suppose here I want to create a hole. For that again, click on press pull. Then click inside this rectangle, take your cursor inside and here you can specify the depth. Suppose depth is 150, enter and escape. Then press shift and middle mouse button. You can orbit it and see it. So in this way, this rectangular blind hole is created. Then to give color to this object, double click on it. And from here you can choose your desired color. Then press escape. Now here we have given color to complete 3D object. Suppose I want to give different color to this surface. For that, click here on this arrow near the extrude faces and click on color faces. Then select this face and this face, enter and choose your color. Okay. Now this command is still running. Click on color and choose this face and this face. Enter and suppose this one. Okay. Then press escape. So in this way you can give color to individual surface also. Then you can view this object in different visual styles. To change visual style, you will have to click here. And here is first is 2D wireframe. It will show object in line work. Then again click here and conceptual will show object with some light effect. Then hidden will not show hidden lines. Then the realistic will show object in actual color. Then shaded and realistic is same. Then shaded with edges will show edges. Then shades of gray, it will show in gray color. Then sketchy, show in sketchy lines. Then in this wireframe, actually this is a 3D wireframe. Then it will again show in wireframe, but this XYZ axis will look solid when compared with 2D wireframe. In 2D wireframe, those are in lines, but in this 3D wireframe, those are in solids. And in X-ray, it will show the object transparent. Then normally, we will be using this shaded with edges. Then to see different views, click here. And from here, you can watch different views. Suppose I want to see from top side. So for that, click on this top. So it will show top view. Then right view. Then front view. Then here it will show four isometric views. This is southwest isometric, then southeast isometric, then northeast isometric, and northwest isometric. So most of the time we will be using this AC isometric. Then to orbit this object, you can also give command from here. Click on orbit. Then press and hold first mouse button and drag the mouse. And in between you can release it and again press it and drag the mouse. But in this orbit you cannot go ahead. It gets locked in this position. So if you want to rotate it full 360 degree, then you will have to click on this arrow and use this free orbit. So in this free orbit, you can rotate it in any direction without any restrictions. And there is one more orbit. Click on this arrow, that is continuous orbit. For this, press first mouse button and drag the mouse in any direction and release the mouse. So it will show object rotating in that direction. And if you want to rotate it fast, just drag it fast, and if you drag it slow, it will rotate it slow. And to bring back to our original view, click here and select SE isometric. So it will show you the original view. So that's all. In the next tutorial, we will solve some exercises based on what we learn in this tutorial. And after that, we will learn next set of commands in 3D environment. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.